me. Girl, don't you see? There ain't nobody gonna take from me. Daddy said to live your life, rolling her down on your eyes. You got to give all your heart if you want to. You got to give all your heart if you want to. You got to give all your heart if you want to. Be set free.
Went by the Papago campgrounds, and now where we're at right now is Papago Well, Tule Well. So the Tule Well is 32 miles this way. There is a flag right there showing that there's water here, and then there is the windmill. So here we are, kind of, I'm gonna say somewhere in the half, you know, of where we're gonna be. And then there's these flags right here to show people that there's water. And, you know, regardless what your feelings are, man, I've been out. I've had trouble in the desert before, if you've seen some of my videos. And it's pretty incredible that this is here, because I don't care what the situation is. You don't want anybody dying from not having any water. And man, that's got water. And that's pretty cool. That is pretty cool that it's out here. It's also cool that there's water. Now, another thing that a lot of people, now what they'll do is they'll take these tires, and they've got them tied together. What they'll do is they'll drag them behind a Jeep, and then what it does is smooths this out, right? So they can see somebody walking across the road, and they can tell that somebody's there. Now, it'll smooth this out just like this. So when you're walking across here, right here, you know, you see a footprint. Now, I'm told that a lot of times what they'll try to do is put carbon on their feet and then walk across that. But if you look at this area right here and you see how it's been done and you see this footprints, I mean, you can still see, if you know what you're looking at, you can still see that the ground's been disturbed. And then they'll know you've shot across this road. I'm sure there's ways around it, but that's a pretty easy way to be able to see that there's been some activity, so they try to control what's going on out here. Because, you know, the reality is the amount of deaths is just unbelievable here. I mean, it really is. The fact that there's no wall, you know, like a wall or not, it keeps people from coming across that are going to die out here, whether, you know, they should be here or not. That's not the decision. The discussion is that people are dying out here because this is treacherous, and they're not qualified to come across here. You know, just like this, a lot of the pioneers that died out here in the late 1700s and early 1800s did. So it's a pretty trick setup. You can tell that they've definitely got their wear. And pretty cool. Now we're gonna walk on up on the other side of this tank. And we're gonna go right, looks like a concrete tank up here. So we're gonna take a walk right through here and take a look and see what's down here. You know, it's just, again, it's such a peaceful day. It'd be a great day to hike out here. And there is a tank right there for sure. Let's go up there and take a look and see what we've got. See if there's any water in it. It looks fairly modern. I can see water from it right there. Also can see bees. Lots of bees. So there's water right there. And then there is what we hope is not African. If you see us run really quick, you'll know why. Well, We're not sprinting to the truck, so that's a good sign. Look how lush this desert is today. Wow. It is just incredible. And you know, that sign right there, when you see that blue flag, that means basically I'm not going to die today. That's really what that blue flag means. It means that we're not going to die today. So how incredible is that? I mean, I'm glad to see them because, man, dying out in the desert. See, the problem, a lot of it, too, is not only that the water, it's when you run out of salt in your body, you also make some really bad decisions because you're not thinking accurately. And you might have water on you and die with water. Because once you lose the salt in your body, even if you have water, there's a pretty good chance you're probably not going to make it. So even though you have water, sometimes isn't necessarily the only thing if you don't have any salt in your body at that time. So that's why I always make sure that I have some type of salt in me every time I go hiking, especially in heat, because hiking in heat is a whole nother animal, completely different animal. So we're going to go on down the road, and we're 32 miles from Thule, and that's quite a long way on the gravel road. So we're going to get back on the trail, and we'll see where the trail takes us, and we'll be getting back out. Got a grave coming up for you. I think you're going to want to see. Dinner pack.
Cocina del Diablo. Look at the picture of that. It's like Cocina del Diablo. That means kitchen of the devil.
The devil's kitchen.
Yeah. Look at that. What kind of
some kind of military tank.
Flammable.
That's where they keep the fuel. They just load the fuel up. We are coming up on the famous Dave O'Neill grave. Now, Dave died in 1916 from exposure. And he had his two compadres come by, because what happened was his mules ran off and he died on this spot. And they buried him where he died, right here. So a lot of people have came out here and put some cool stuff here. Dave got a little bottle, got some glasses, got some coins, looks like pesos, which is good. Got some shells, got a green snake, light bulb. Now here's the funny story. So his two guys divided up his goods and they buried him right here and put these very rocks right here. Now the funny thing about it was, is, you know, 2 weeks later they ran out of tobacco. They remembered that Dave had tobacco on him, so they dug him up. And one of the guys made a statement that said, you know what, that tobacco was just as fresh as I'd had it in my pocket. And I'm telling you what, I don't know if I believe that story or not, but it's a good story. But Dave died on this spot in 1916. And they stacked these very rocks. And then throughout the years, since 1960, people have been coming down the Devil's Highway. And there's some kind of different stuff that they've left for Dave. There's a snake. And then, oh man, you always need that, especially you're out here. Bullets. Okay, these are some old coins right here. I'm telling you what, some of this stuff's been here a while.
Don't steal any of the money.
Well, you try not to, but look, those are, how old is that?
Look at the
litres. It's Roosevelt, so it's not that old.
Oh, you ruined my dream. But look at all this weird stuff that they put. Tire weight, you know.
You need those.
Oh, look, here's a cowboy boot. Right there, okay. And then, look, there's keys. Somebody said, honey, oh, look, a wish. No, is that a wishbone or is that a?
It's a lighter.
Lighter, yeah, in case you want to light one up. Look at this thing. Cash money, it says. You like that, Maria?
I like this.
Oh, here's a buffalo nickel. Oh, no, it's no.
And this is amazing. It's amazing. There's a tire gauge. There's a little, a couple horseshoes. That'd be nice. You'd need those. Those actually look extremely old. And then sunglasses, because, I mean, you're out here in the sun.
I Well, what do you think? You want to dig them up?
You know, we could. Well, they've taken the tobacco, and that's the only thing I would have been after, you know.
Too late.
Too late for that.
Too late.
Very nice. So that is the grave of Dave O'Neill. And
this is kind of cool.
It's a pretty good shell right here. That's your normal.
It's a 50 caliber.
50 caliber right here.
Look at this, Jeff.
That's a Marine. I didn't know he was a Marine or not.
Nice.
Well, they didn't have them then.
So look at there. Fun stuff. Very interesting. A piece of somebody's, what, a fender? You know?
I have no idea.
Well, let's move on. I think we've seen now. Who knows if the story's true or not, but you know what? It's still cool. So, you know, I think that's very funny.
O'Neill Pass.
Yeah. Oh, this is O'Neill's Pass.
Yeah.
And he passed at O'Neill's Pass. This is where he passed. O'Neill's Pass. So the rule of thumb is, if you're going to bury your buddy out in the desert and he has tobacco, don't bury him with the tobacco. Put it in your pocket and smoke it. This might be desolate, but it doesn't feel like it. That's what's so funny about it.
Yeah.
It really doesn't.
And mile 40, the Yuma Trail or Sonora Trail.
So this is the real trail right here.
Have been on.
Now this is the plier right here where a Marine jet hit a red-tailed hawk and crashed. Now the great news is that the pilot walked away, but not too much later, a Border Patrol helicopter also crashed on the plier and that pilot also walked away. So you might call this the Yuma Triangle. This road is really, would be interesting if you had water in it, wouldn't it? Because this is really interesting how it's grooved out. You know, in this very location in 1890, of all things for them to find, they found a camel skeleton. And they believe it was a camel that escaped when they had the U.S. Army were using camels in the Jolly Corps. Isn't that incredible that they found a camel skeleton out here? And the Mexicans that found it said it was a highly prized. So it just is, this place is absolutely magical. Of all the places I've ever been, I'm gonna tell you that this has to rate in Arizona probably my favorite place that I've ever been. Now, I know in July, there's gonna be a whole different thought process than there is in the end of February, but still, this place is just absolutely believable, unbelievable. It really is unbelievable. You know, here's somebody that didn't make it on the trail right here. 1871. N-A-M, is that an A? E-R, Namer? Maybe Namer, 1871. So in 1871, somebody actually took all those and then these stone crosses down here. You know, some of the tragedies of the Devil's Highway right here. And they bury them where they fall. Man, to get this far though and not make it, it just seems like a shame. But it is what it is, right? That's why it's the Devil's Highway. You know, this by far has to be, hands down, the most beautiful desert I've seen anywhere. I mean, as I walk through here, I mean, this area is just, it's magnificent. I can't even explain, you know, the beauty of this place. And, you know, one thing I came out here was for, you know, the road of the devil. And I'm sure in the heat it is. And I'm sure if you had to travel this far and you were still, we're about 60 miles in right now from Ajo. you might feel the same thing. You might feel like it was the road of the desert, but or the road of the devil. But I tell you what, this is the most pristine desert I've ever seen. I mean, I can't hardly even get over how nice this is. Look at this place. There's some nice rock. On another day, I'd climb that hill and take a look up in those caves. Because there's definitely two croppings out there. Not that there's anything up there, but there's a nice mountain lion looking at us. Look how gorgeous this desert is. It's just beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. And to think that since 1540, you know, even before that, I mean, the ancients traveled this path way before that, but up to 1540, people traveled down this stretch of road. I'll tell you what, this is just absolutely beautiful. I'm just in awe of the beauty of this place. I mean, it is absolutely spectacular. Coming down this very road, you can almost like hear the clop of the horses' hooves of the conquistadors, or the donkey that Kino rode as he went through these very hills. You know, that guy traveled through these very hills by himself and outlasted all the natives that tried to, you know, for some reason they let him travel through. And then you saw the 49ers come through here and the dreamers. And they came through these very hills, and I doubt that they saw the beauty that I'm seeing right now, because they were just trying to get to Thule, which was another 10 miles, which, you know, at one point, that might have been another day and a half. What did they get in an oxen? Maybe 8 miles a day? Maybe 10? So their trip through here would have been 2 weeks. Man, that would have been, the beauty would have been diminished by the fact that you were thirsty. For sure. But I just can't get over the beauty of this. This is just beautiful. It's kind of nice to get out of the car, because we're doing this on a day trip. So it's kind of amazing to think what you can get done and still get out and still enjoy it. You know, most of the time people don't think it's a day trip. But it definitely is. Now, if you happen to look out and see this pale casita, that kind of tells you right off that you're in Thule Springs. Now, what would a casita be doing sitting out here in the middle of absolutely nowhere? Well, you know, in 1980, the civil engineers at the Luke Air Force Base decided that all these weary travelers along the highway, the devil needed a place to maybe curl up and get a good night's sleep while they were on their journey. So they built this in 1980. Now, this is an area that's called the Cabeza Prieta, which means basically that this is a wildlife refuge. Now, this was established roughly right around 1941. Now, if you journey behind the building and you go up on the hilltop, what you're going to find is you're behind a monument. Now, that monument was established in 1941. And that basically said that the Cabeza Prieta, the wildlife refuge, was now established to be able to make sure that the longhorn sheep and the pronghorn had a place that they could repopulate this area, which they had been roaming for thousands of years. So if you go up on that hill, you're going to see the work of a bunch of groups of Boy Scouts from different areas that came down here and put this monument in place. And so it's something you're not going to want to miss, because look at the beautiful view that you get right here. And back up north from there is Christmas Pass. Now, this is the problem when you get behind a convoy of anything here on this road. I can't see people wanting to eat the other people's dust, but I guess they do. But there's like four or five Jeeps in front of us, and it's a mess. I don't think I'd want to go that route, but some people do. These poor guys in the back got to be eating dust for 100 miles.
That wouldn't be any fun. Don't you think, John?
Yeah, I'm one of them.
Well, it's gotten to be the end of the trail. Well, it's time to air up. It's time to end of the trail. And it was a great run. We got done at what, about 2:30. Got back to the highway here. And still had plenty of time. Got behind some Jeep guys that were in a big convoy, which slowed us up pretty good. But still, the road was really nice. A lot of construction, believe it or not, on it. But it was a good trip. And saw a lot of cool stuff. So leg one's done. You know, it would make a good day run. We still got to get back into town, but you know, it was a good time, and we had a lot of good fun. So glad you came with us. Please like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you can get all the stuff we need. So, what did you think of that trip?
Awesome.
Awesome?
Yeah.
It was awesome.
Leg one
was a good leg.
Touch anything.